Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the David Ortiz Player Lock Farewell Tour series here at MLB The Show 16 on the PS4. If you're not familiar with what a Player Lock series or Player Lock gameplay is, it's when you play a franchise, but you take and focus on one player as if it were a road to the show, but that allows you to focus in on a real major league player playing in the league right now. Don't have to create anybody. You could just follow somebody who may be your favorite in the league, and in this case, David Ortiz, going through his final season in the majors, and we're trying to commemorate that by playing along here in MLB The Show 16. So today, he'll be taking on Cole Hamels and the Texas Rangers and stepping in there with 30 home runs, and we haven't even hit the month of July yet, not even to the All-Star break. He is killing it in real life. He really is, but not quite at this pace. As far as the home runs, and there's number 31 into the second deck in right field. Poppy strikes again, and he has victimized yet another pitcher in the first half of this season. 31 round trippers now for David Ortiz. The way he's playing in real life has people asking themselves, does he really have to retire? Is this really it? He's playing at such a high level still. He's still so clutch. Why? Why does he have to go? I mean, I know it's great, like we've talked before on this series, to go out on your own terms, to go out on top and not have to hang on until someone else tells you, you know what, I think it's time to go. Your skills are diminishing. You can no longer help our team the way we need. We need to go in a different direction. No. If he leaves and truly walks out after the season, he'll be going out knowing he could still play. I mean, this is just absolutely wonderful to see him go out this way. Anyway, that ball hit to right center field and will be caught out by the center fielder ranging over there to make the catch. So the game ends up a 4-2 Texas victory. So David Ortiz goes deep, but his team loses the first game of this three-game series. Next up, it'll be Rick Porcello versus Yu Darvish. Okay, pretty good matchup here in Arlington. You see both teams wearing throwbacks. The Red Sox throwing it way back to another era right there. Oh yeah, let's see if that brings some luck there. Wearing the throwbacks, he's going to reach for that one and just kind of loft it out softly into right field. Falls harmlessly for a hit, and the runner, oh, very close play at third, will scoot on over from first to third on that hit. So that's one of the softer hits you're going to see Ortiz gets as he just flares it on out there. This one hit harder, but right into the shift. They'll throw him out from the outfield grass. Okay, there you go. He's 1-for-2 now against Yu Darvish. They've got a 2-0 lead, and he comes up again. 3-1 count, and he rips it. And second baseman has nothing to say about that one. It's right past him, and it's his second hit of the game. 2-for-3 is David Ortiz. Can he make it 3-for-4? Let's try again. The DH in the box. 3-1 Red Sox lead, and again, it's going to be at the second baseman, who throws him out. So 2-for-4 on the day. Will the Red Sox get the win and even the series? Looks like they're on their way, and they do close it down. Oh, it got a little interesting there, though. 4-3 is your final score. So both teams split a game to start this series. Let's see who takes the 2-1 series win. And David Price is hoping it's him going to the mound right here. And he has really gotten things going now, 9-5. And he's really stepped that up lately. The guy on the left-hand side, yeah, hopefully he won't be starting any brawls today. Let's just leave it at that. I'll just leave that there. That was quite a righty packed against Jose Bautista. But hopefully it won't come down to anyone having to put up their dukes today. Hopefully he can settle it just on the baseball field in a normal fashion. That ball hits the pitcher and careens away, but the throw will get him. That is David Ortiz running the line there, not Mookie Betts or anybody. So they will throw him out, and the pitcher looks like he's going to be okay. He'll continue. 3-0 is your Boston lead, however, and that pitch has hit the opposite field. And it's out of here. He sneaks it out to left. Opposite field shot. Kind of the swing and the approach you want to take when hitting at Fenway with the green monster, although I don't know if that would have been high enough to clear the monster. It clears the high wall here, however, and is a home run for David Ortiz, number 32 on the season. As we are almost into the month of July now, 382 feet, one of his shorter home runs. And, well, like we said, they all count the same, however. Let's see the replay on this one. Just able to muscle it and get that ball lofted up in the air enough to take it on out to left. How much did it clear by? Well, it's not a wall scraper by any means. Two, three rows back. So there you go. Number 32 on the season. It's 4-0 Boston. Can he have a multiple home run game? He has had quite a few of those this year. That one's going to be smashed to Prince Fielder, who steps on the bag. Boston continues to lead with that 4-0 score. Here's going to be a high chopper to Prince Fielder. And, oh, interesting race to the bag. Prince Fielder and David Ortiz. Prince Fielder wins it by a foot. Steps on that bag and retires him on that play. David Price, though, he goes the distance. Like my favorite Cake song, he's going the distance. Anyway, 5-0 shutout and complete game for David Price. Ortiz had just the one hit. It was a home run, and it turns out that was enough to win the game. So the Red Sox find themselves 6.5 games out of first place. That belongs to the Toronto Blue Jays right now. We'll get back around to playing them. But today, this is the start of a 3-game series at Tropicana Field in Tampa. Will the Red Sox be able to take advantage of a team that is struggling in their own division here? Well, we'll have to find out. Can they take it to the Rays? First inning, runner on first. David Ortiz stepping to the plate. And the first pitch he will see is put in play and hit hard, but right at the first baseman, who does not have time to double up the runner, as he very alertly dove back to the bag. But that was smashed, and he had nothing to show for it. That ball's not hit hard at all. The catcher going to make an easy play right there. Either way, result is the same. Ortiz is out in his first couple at bats. Let's go to his next at bat in the fifth. He reaches out, and we saw him hit a home run kind of like this. This one he gets under a little too much, and that's not even going to be close to getting out of here. Let's see if he can get something done in this next at bat. Boston is up 3-0, so that's nice. That one, again, did not go very far. The pitcher handles the duties this time and throws him out. So Ortiz does not get a hit in this one, but the Red Sox do win 3-2. Oh, they had to hang on again. Tampa came with a couple runs there, but Clay Buchholz and company got it done. So they win the first game. What they'd really like out of this series is a sweep so they can kind of put some pressure on the Blue Jays, but I'm sure Chris Archer has other ideas, as you see his numbers right there. Mookie Betts as well, hitting .249. You'd like to pick that up a little bit, but 13 homers, 37 RBI. He's definitely pitching in offensively. So David Ortiz, speaking of pitching in offensively, he and his 32 home runs, but that is going to be a ground out. And he's got to wait for another at bat here to try to get a hit. Tampa up 2-1 in the third inning. Poppy at the plate, and he hits it hard, and it is caught there. Looked like that could have easily been extra bases, but instead it is tracked down by the right fielder, and David Ortiz out again. Still looking for his first hit in this series against Tampa. Will it come in this at-bat? They're down 3-2 in the fifth. No, strike three in the dirt, so they'll throw down, but you got ample time to throw as David Ortiz is lumbering down there. So still no hits for Ortiz in this series. They trail 3-2. Next time up, still 3-2. And man, a solo homer would go a long way right here. Well, it's not a home run, but it is ripped down the right field line. And they'll play this in, giving him no chance to go to second base with his speed. So he will come up with a big hit right there, however. And now you got runners at the corners. 3-2 count and two outs means he's off with the pitch. But this is skied out to center field, and it will be tracked down, so the inning is over. Boston does not get that tie and run home, and they lose the game 3-2. One hit for David Ortiz, but yeah. He needed a big fly on that one to tie the thing up. Didn't happen. So again, they split the first two games of a series. And the last game of the month will be the last game in this Tampa Bay series. Let's see if they can get that win. Take 2 of 3 and head on out of here and into the month of July. David Ortiz in this series, just 1-for-8 with a single. He'll look to improve on that. Boston already up 1-0 in the top of the first. And a runner on first. Nobody out. This pitch is hit in the air. Is this one too high? Come on, hit a catwalk somewhere. The stadium is famous for that. Ball getting stuck in the catwalks, and then they got to decide if it's a foul ball or a double or a home run or what the call is going to be. You know, put some pressure on the umpires. 1-1 now in the fourth inning, and that one's really high also, but it's not going very far. Catcher looking to make the play over by the Red Sox dugout, and he does. David Ortiz gets cheated out of him in a bat right there with a foul pop out. 5-1. Tampa putting it on him now. That's not good. It looks like we're going to lose this series. That's just a routine ground out to second base. 7-1. Ouch. Taking it on the chin today. This one hit to right field. Again, high. Come on, hit a catwalk. No? It's just too simple right there. Got to make it hard on them. Anyway, we didn't make it hard on them at all in this game. They win 7-1. If you're a team looking to gain ground in the division, that's not the way to do it. Losing to the teams below you in the division. But that is exactly what has happened here. We lose 2 out of 3 games and we're going to have to regroup. So that is the end of the month of June. Going to turn the page on the calendar now to July, almost to the All-Star break. Got a handful of series before that happens at Fenway Park. Then they'll take a short break for the All-Star game, which I'm assuming David Ortiz will be a part of, as well as the Home Run Derby with 32 home runs already. We'll see you next time for more David Ortiz. Thanks for watching videos here on SGU. Go ahead and subscribe on YouTube at Sports Gaming Universe. Follow me on Twitter at NotasFan for all the latest info. And go ahead and check out that official Facebook page as well. Looking for SGU merchandise? SportsGamingUniverse.Spreadshirt.com is a place. All summer long, I'm partnering with FanDuel to bring you some fun daily fantasy sports action. Go to FanDuel.com/SportsGamingUniverse and use the promo code SGU to get a free entry into a 50-50 league. That's FanDuel.com/SportsGamingUniverse.